Good morning from Panhandle Outdoors, America's only daily outdoor TV show. Your source for fishing, hunting, and information for folks who enjoy the great outdoors. Now sit back, relax. It's Panhandle Outdoors.
Good morning, folks. Welcome to Panhandle Outdoors. I'm Winston Chester. Got a great show lineup today. Hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving. I know y'all all ate too much, including myself, but here we are on a Friday after Thanksgiving. We call it all kinds of things, Black Friday. I always call it Outdoor Friday because we always love doing things in outdoors on a Friday after Thanksgiving. But I know a lot of folks are shopping, and I want to get as far away as I can. So just as soon as it's over, I'm headed to the woods up there between Bristol and Greensboro. I'll be hunting, dog hunting with my nephew and his hunting crew up there, and looking forward to it. So we got to get started. The weather today brought to us by Haney Technical Center, high 77, low 52, water temperature 69. The tide chart, look at it real quick, just neap tide, so I know some folks are going to fish. I'm going to fish tomorrow. Low tide is 406, high 653. Marine forecast, west at about 6. Fishing, I'm going to give you fishing game times so we get it done already. 8:48 to 10:48, and then tonight, 9:09 to 11:09. That's the morning and night time. And let's go ahead and do our Tarpon Dog Seafood giveaway right now, since it's a Friday, and so we won't forget it, okay? Our first, we're looking at our first $20 gift certificate. Is going to be for April Cutchins. April, congratulations on your $20 gift certificate to Tarpon Dog Seafood, and Big Red Snapper is going to Phil Hester. Phil Hester, I hope Phil's still up, okay, because I know he likes to watch the show. All right, that's it right there. Now, let's go and go ahead. I tell you what, let's go ahead and draw for a dozen baked oysters over here in real time, okay, because those folks can really put some oysters up on Callaway, on the Weewaw Highway, and that winner's going to be Greg Taylor. Greg Taylor, all right? We'll give them all kinds of stuff. Now, let's take a look. I got a couple of pictures. Let's look at those real quick, too, okay? What's going on? This is right before Thanksgiving over here in Howard Creek. Brenda Hendricks, former mayor of Parker over there, and Howard Hendricks, they do a lot of serious fishing, and they catch a lot of fish, folks. Another great day of fishing, going to Pepper. This was last Saturday, and then headed home early morning to go to church. They really enjoy fishing, Brenda and Howard. Okay, now, here was Zach and Brody Cullen, two of my former students. They were there duck hunting in West Bay and at sunrise. That's always a beautiful moment. Those moments right there before the ducks start coming in, the sun's coming up. Great shot over there in West Bay. And let's see, here's it. They had a good morning, folks. Look, check out these redheads and canvasbacks. Nice hunt, fellas. Good job. I got to show this. When your Chinese takeaway is undercooked, hope you understand that. I just put a little bit of humor in on this Friday morning. And Steve Cook got a nice buck here. Great morning in the woods. Nice buck right there. And good job, Steve, working with the sheriff's office now. How about my mother-in-law, Elaine? Not my mother-in-law, okay? Over in West Bay, Elaine Kelly Clements. Good job, Miss Clements, over there. And, okay, that's the pictures. I also want to do a quick quick fishing report. Like I say, I'm headed, I'm going to hunt today, fish tomorrow. It's going to be good fishing. It's really a good time to go. Remember, it's free saltwater, license free tomorrow and this weekend. So we've got some folks coming in. Just go take them fishing. The flounder fishing off the docks are really good. Like San Andreas State Park's going to be good. Also, surf fishing is going to be good. Bass fishing, you saw the video. There are a lot of bass being caught. Not some huge bass, but a lot of bass are being caught. So we've got a lot of things coming up. But here's what we're going to get ready for. We had the video yesterday and what people are thankful for, and I hope you enjoy that. We go to, I don't say a lot of trouble, it's very enjoyable stuff, just finding different people and what they're thankful for. And I know as y'all sat around yesterday and gave thanks and all, I know you sort of had a lot of time to reflect and all. It's just an awesome time. It's Thanksgiving, and it's behind us now, but always some great memories coming from it. I hope you had some great memories with your family and all. We got Christmas coming up next. Be a lot of it's a busy time of the year. A lot of things going on. Don't forget to relax and do some things outdoors. But as far as fishing and all this weekend, it's going to be good. The river is in excellent shape. You just saw now Howard and Brenda, they go fishing a lot over the intercoastal and on the lower end of the river. But the brim fishing has been excellent. So if you want to do some brim fishing this weekend, it's going to be really good. All the rivers and creeks are low. We talked about that. Also, I may try to catch some whiting. I enjoy catching whiting during the holidays, especially during Christmas holiday, but The whiting fishing, you know, is really good eating, so it'd be a good time to do that. Now, I used to use shrimp a lot, but it's just little strips of fish bites work really good. And don't forget to always, you know, support our sponsors. These folks come on and sponsor our show, and they have everything we need as far as outdoor stuff. And, you know, Brad was on Wednesday, got a lot of good clothing stuff, and it's everything we need to, you need to buy for Christmas. You can buy from local folks. I do that not just with the sponsors. The things I need, I buy from them. Other stuff I buy from as much as I can from local people. So I always encourage you to do that. Small Business America is just important to all of us. Now we're going to get lined up. This is going to be a hunting video with Ashley. It did so well the other day. So many people liked it, and it's hunting season. So let's go ahead. We're going to take a break. We'll come back and show this video with Ashley taking that big buck. But again, I tell you, just enjoy the thrill that a young person has when they take something like that. It's an awesome video. So we'll be right back.
Good morning here from Tennessee. This is a special edition of Cast and Call Outdoors on Panhandle Outdoors. As you know, we've moved to Tennessee, so one of the good things about that is we get to hunt right here. We moved on a farm. You may see or hear some of our goats. So this morning, we're going to take you on a hunt with Ashley and my dad.
Thank you. Oh my goodness. That was more nervous than my first buck.
He's got a big old body.
Dad, I saw movement through the leaves, and I've been seeing squirrels right there. And then I saw, like, it was bigger. And so I looked, and so I got my scope ready, and I saw antlers, and then I saw that they were big antlers, but he was still through the leaves, and he was, like, quartering towards me, and so I was gonna shoot, but I didn't want to, because I didn't think I would get him, and because I couldn't see him very well or where I was shooting, and then he turned broadside, and I was about to pull the trigger, and he came running up the hill right there, and I was like...
I could see the end of your barrel going...
Did you think I was gonna miss?
When he gets that close, you know, you had to get him right there where you did, or you weren't going to be able to get him. He was going to be so close.
Mm-hmm. I was like, shoot his back.
Yeah, shot him right in the back, which shut him down. Then you had to put him back.
I felt bad when he was trying to crawl away. Thank you.
Shake my hand.
Thank you, Lord.
That was a beautiful morning. Youth weekend, Tennessee. How old are you?
13. First hour of youth weekend.
Oh, we've been here a couple hours.
Seriously? We kept seeing all these, we didn't see them, but we kept hearing these things, and we were like, that's deer. And so Dad was like, get ready over here. Then get ready over here. Because we kept hearing them all around us, and they sounded just like deer. So I would get my gun ready, and then a squirrel would run out, and it was a squirrel. And then we actually saw a little doe, but she was behind us. And then there were just squirrels everywhere. We thought they were all deer. I was getting all excited and shaking, thinking it was going to be a buck that would walk up. And it was a squirrel.
Ashley, that was a great buck.
Thank you. I wish you could have got him during bow season.
That's all right.
I guess it's just luck. He just came running right towards us.
Oh, good stand placement.
I wanted to ask you, like, do I shoot? But I thought I couldn't tell where he was in the scope, and I didn't want to talk too loud.
Did you hear me say the wind was in our favor? So you don't smell us.
While he was in all the different angles he was getting himself in, I was just seeing those hunter safety pictures. And I was like, wait, was it quartering towards or quartering away that's good for a shot? And then I was like, wait, did they say you can shoot him in the front? And it was stressing me out. And then he turned broadside, and I was like slowly starting to pull the trigger, and he ran up the hill.
You want to go see him? You want to wait and shoot a doe?
I don't care what we do. I don't think a doe's going to come up on a dead deer. When I first saw him, I thought he was like a 4-point because when I just saw the horns, but I knew his body was pretty big. And then there was just this little clearing in the trees, and he turned his whole head and looked right at us, and I saw his actual rack, and I was like, okay, I can shoot him. Six, seven, eight, nine. And if you count that other little tiny one, it's 10. Goodness. Oh, it's heavier than they look. Ugh. Did you count him as a 9 or a 10 point?
You'd be a 9.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
What a great deer.
I can't believe this.
That's the big one.
Really?
Yep. See how tall his G2s are?
I don't know what G2s are.
The tall
These?
One. Yep. Yep.
Oh my goodness. This is amazing.
What an incredible deer. Look at that.
Dad, this is awesome. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
You do all the work for it and then let us kill the deer.
That's a great deer.
Wow. Yeah, I'm excited for you.
All right, let me take a good picture here. So, pick him up, pick his antlers up, and tilt his head down, and hold it out from me a little bit.
Right there. Like.
Yeah. And hold the base of his antlers. There you go. Your mother just texted question marks. Okay, let's see where you are.
I haven't even eaten breakfast this morning.
Let me stay there. Hear him a little more so you look right through his antlers.
I'm Ashley Woodrick of Panhandle Outdoors, and I love Dr. Buttram, my pretty straight teeth, and this Tennessee buck.
You saw it? I just saw the picture.
Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Is that exciting, isn't it?
That's awesome. Wow, that's I'm so glad y'all are here.
I haven't seen it either.
Okay, so we just kept hearing these things and we were sure they were deer just all around us. So I kept changing position of my gun and getting really ready and like nervous. And then a squirrel would jump out and it was a squirrel. And then Dad saw a little doe, but she was not in shoot. She was close to us, but she was super quiet. She was behind us, so we couldn't shoot her, and she just like disappeared. And so we were sitting there, and we were just waiting, and I was about to fall asleep. And so I was sitting there, and I was like, and then this movement catches my eyes down the trail. And so through the trees, and I just saw it, and at first I thought it was like a squirrel or something, because I could barely see it through the trees. And then I saw it, and I was like, that's a deer. And I saw a little bit of antler, and I thought it was a 4-point, so I was about to stop aiming. And then there was this little circle about that big in the trees, and he looked literally through it right towards us, and I saw his antlers. Dad was telling me, breathe through your nose, because you don't want your breath to smell. And I was going, and then I was like, trying to breathe through my nose, but I couldn't breathe. And so... he was like quartering towards me, and I was thinking about the hunter safety course, and I was like, wait, is it, how do you shoot? Is it quartering towards or quartering away? And I was like, I don't know if I should take it or not. And then he turns broadside, and I saw, and I was gonna take the shot, and so I started to pull the trigger, and he turned towards us and started running towards us. And I just started.
He started running towards you?
Yes, right towards the stand, because the wind was perfect. It was blowing to us. And it scared me so much, and I was breathing so hard, and I was about to wait and see if he would stop and turn broadside, and he started walking, and the only shot I had was at his back. And Dad said, shoot. And so I shot.
He was about to be underneath her shooting. Oh,
and yeah. So I was kind of rising up. I wasn't sitting down anymore, and I was rising up to get a good shot.
And the whole stand was...
And Dad goes, shoot. And so I shot him, and he just, like, dropped right there. So when he dropped... he like laid there for a minute and then he started to crawl away on his front legs. Uh-huh. And Dad said, shoot again. And I was still so nervous and I was sure I was gonna miss the second time, but I shelled it and shot him again and he dropped.
Oh, wow, cool.
I'm so proud of you.
But he looked big in the scope
And then I, while I was walking up towards him, he looked smaller. And then when I got up to him, he just looked huge. It was crazy.
Let's go see him. Can we go see him?
That is awesome.
Yeah.
What'd y'all do when y'all heard the shot?
Well, we kind of just looked at each other, and I said, was that them? And, or no, she said, was that them? And I said, yes, ma'am. And then we heard another shot. And so then I thought that y'all just had a bunch of deer, and y'all shot like Whitney did that one time. And none of them ran off, and y'all just shot another one, but only one ran away. And then we kept saying, was that y'all, and sending question marks and stuff. And then he said something and sent this picture of the buck, and it was huge. And I like went like this and almost like screamed. And I started counting the points on it and everything. And it was like, I told Mom it was those kind of bucks that you see killed on the Outdoor Channel when they go to Illinois and kill the big white tail bucks and stuff. It was huge. And the rack was so tall and wide too.
Wow!
9 points.
Did you know that she shot at me?
I knew she shot a deer, but I didn't want to see it until we came and got it.
Wow, Ashley. That's amazing.
It's a good size too.
That's amazing. That's amazing.
That's a big deer.
I'm proud of you.
That is huge. I'm so proud of you, baby.
Thank you.
Opening morning.
Oh, my.
Hey, how you do? I'm Winston.
Steve Myers.
Hey, Steve. Oh, good to meet you.
You too.
That is beautiful. Nice healthy book.
Thanks for watching America's only daily outdoor TV show, Panhandle Outdoors with Winston Chester, featuring hunting, fishing, and other activities and information to help you enjoy the great outdoors. Join us next time for Panhandle Outdoors.